An intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, is a guided ballistic missile with a minimum range of 5,500 kilometers, that's 3,400 miles, primarily designed for nuclear weapons delivery. Nuclear strikes can be carried out from land, air, and sea, and this is known as the nuclear triad. ICBMs are designed to fill the land-based role. Russia, the United States, China, and India are the only countries currently known to possess operational land-based ICBMs. Israel's maintained secrecy regarding actual deployment. North Korea, too, has tested several ICBMs, but they're not officially deployed. France deploys only submarine launched ballistic missiles, SLBM. In this video, Defense Updates lists top 6 intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBMs. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. On the 28th of November 2017, North Korea stated that it had successfully tested its Hwasong 15, a newly developed ICBM that could deliver heavy nuclear warheads anywhere in the continental United States. State news agency KCNA called the missile the most powerful ICBM and said it meets the goal of the completion of the rocket weaponry system deployment set by DPRK, or the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. The then Defense Secretary Jim Mattis had expressed concern, emphasizing that there were major technical advances on display in the 53-minute flight. Mr. Mattis said in the White House, "It went higher, frankly, than any previous shot they've taken." He added, "The bottom line is it's a continued effort to build a threat, a ballistic missile threat that endangers world peace, regional peace, and certainly the United States." Hwasong-15 traveled nearly 600 miles, or 965 kilometers, and landed in the Sea of Japan. The important fact is that it was launched with a lofted trajectory, and if it was launched on a standard trajectory, it would have been able to travel 13,000 kilometers, or 8,100 miles. The two-stage missile is thought to be capable of carrying a payload of 1,000 kilograms, or 2,200 pounds. The JERICHO 3 is the third missile to serve as Israel's land-based nuclear deterrent. The JERICHO 3 is believed to have a range between 4,800 and 6,000 kilometers. That's between 2,982 and 3,728 miles. It's capable of carrying a 1,000 kilogram or 2,204 pound warhead payload. Some reports suggest that it's capable of carrying 2 to 3 low-yield MIRV, multiple independent reentry vehicle warheads. So a single missile can hit multiple targets. JERICHO 3 is reportedly solid fueled, meaning it can be launched with minimum preparation, and housed in silos capable of resisting attack. The JERICHO 3, as well as the older generation JERICHO 2 missiles, may be based at Palmachim Air Base. The precise yield of Israel's ICBM warheads is unknown, but unconfirmed reports peg them at 20 kilotons. AGNII 5 is an intercontinental ballistic missile developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization of India. It's the latest iterative development in the AGNII series missiles. Though the stated range is 5,500 kilometers or 3,417 miles, most experts believe it has a maximum range of 8,000 kilometers or 4,970 miles and above. The U.S. Missile Proliferation Survey for the Congressional Research Service puts the possible maximum range at 11,500 kilometers, or 7,145 miles. The missile brings the whole of Asia and most parts of Europe within India's striking range. AGNII 5 is a three-stage solid-fueled ballistic missile and is capable of carrying warheads up to 1,500 kilograms or 3,300 pounds. In the future, it's expected to feature five MIRVs. It's a road and rail mobile missile and uses 8x8 Tatra TEL transporter erector launcher. Minuteman series of missile gained range with the incremental versions, and the Minuteman III is acknowledged to have an operational range of 13,000 kilometers, that's 8,100 miles, though the exact range is classified. As per many analysts, the missile actually can travel as far as 16,000 kilometers or 9,940 miles, depending on the warhead configuration. Minuteman III was the first true MIRV-capable missile. It can carry a maximum of three warheads. It carries W-78 or W-87 warhead. The W-78 has a publicly announced yield of 335 to 350 kilotons of TNT. The W-87 is an improvement on the W-78 and has a max yield of 475 kilotons. Though it's the oldest missile in the list, but it's still very effective for nuclear deterrence role. The Dongfeng 41, or DF-41, is a Chinese nuclear, solid-fueled, road-mobile, intercontinental ballistic missile. DF-41 is the fourth generation of strategic missile developed by China, and is also the latest generation. The development of DF-41 with MIRV technology is reported to be in response to the deployment of the United States National Missile Defense System, which degrades China's nuclear deterrence capability. The missile is reportedly capable of reaching the United States within 30 minutes. It was officially unveiled at the China National Day Military Parade on October 1, 2019. DF-41 is estimated to be capable of carrying 2 to 10 MIRVs. Some analysts think it most likely carries only three warheads, with the additional payload used for many penetration aids. DF-41 is a road mobile ICBM. It's expected to replace one or more of the older ICBMs that are currently present in Chinese inventory. The RS-28 SARMAT is a Russian liquid-fueled, MIRV-equipped, heavy thermonuclear intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, under development by the Makiev Rocket Design Bureau since 2009. It's intended to replace the R-36M ICBM, which is also known as Satan. SARMAT uses liquid propellant, the exact nature of which is classified. It weighs in at a massive 100 tons, making it the heaviest missile in the world. To give viewers a perspective, the Minuteman III has a weight of 35 tons, approximately. According to some estimates, the missile's striking range is about 18,000 kilometers. That's 11,148.6 miles. It also has a payload capability for 10 to 15 warheads, each with a capacity of up to 750 kilotons. This, if true, will make it the most destructive weapon on Earth. To give viewers a perspective, Little Boy atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima had a yield of 15 kilotons of TNT. SARMAT's cumulative explosive power will be 15 warheads multiplied by 75 kilotons. That's around 11,000 kilotons of TNT. The Russian news outlet Sputnik reported in May that an RS-28 rocket is capable of wiping out parts of the Earth the size of France or Texas. And by these figures, it seems that the analysis is correct. The missile's preparation to launch is under 60 seconds, utilizing a highly automated launch system. The missile's payload capacity will enable it to carry up to three avant-garde hypersonic glide vehicles, HGVs, which is under development. It will also have countermeasures designed to defeat anti-missile systems. land-based missiles are vulnerable to preemptive strikes, and hence Russian experts are going to great lengths to shield it. The Sarmat silos will be protected by active protection measures, including 100 guns capable of firing a metallic cloud of 40,000 30mm bullets to an altitude of up to 6 kilometers or 7 miles. The Russians are also planning to protect the Sarmat with their new S-500 air defense systems. On March 30, 2018, the Russian Defense Ministry published a video showing the Sarmat performing its second successful test launch at the Plesetsk Cosmodrome. Sarmat will be operationally deployed by 2021.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.